Reagan, honey, hi. Look, this is a harmless little love scene. There's nothing to worry about.
I know, but I'm just a little bit uncomfortable because there's so many more people here than usual.
Here we go. It's nothing. Oh, hi. What is that?
What, this?
You look like a UPS package.
It's just tape.
No, I know.
Because I don't want anyone to see my full breasts.
Why not? What if you saw a woman nursing a child on the side of the road, breastfeeding a baby with the life-sustaining fluid that only a woman can give that baby? You have to admit, that's a pretty powerful and beautiful statement, no?
Yeah.
Well, we want to make that exact same statement, but no baby. The life-sustaining fluid from her breast. Fluid that only a woman can give. It's a miracle, for crying out loud. Now, as an agent, Bernie, you've got to see the art in that.
That was very touching, Peter. But it's not up to me, it's up to Reagan.
Reagan, what do you say? Let me show the world your Mona Lisas, huh?
I don't know. What do you think, Uncle Bernie?
Reagan, honey, there are many different levels of nudity. So we just need to find a level we can all live with.
I'll be frank. Okay, I'm looking for a level that lets me see nipple.
Sorry, Peter. Can't give you a nipple. Now, I want a half-inch skin barrier around the aureola at all times, and I don't want you anywhere near the return.
Return? What? What's the return?
It's the natural slope below the nipple as it curves armward.
Armward? I don't even know what you're talking about. What? Stuart, take off your shirt.
Peter, I'm the head of production.
Yeah, this is a production meeting. You're helping us out. Come on, take off your shirt.
Why?
Go on, Bernie. You want to hurry that up, please? He doesn't want to wrinkle it.
No.
Here, you don't want to touch him. Use that.
Okay, this is Stuart's return right here. It's this ridge from the underbelly of the breast to the lower armpit. That's off limits. But I'll give you the top of the side and the upper cleavage.
What else?
As far as the buttocks go, we ask that you concentrate on cleft. Please, no crack, Peter. That's very important. Now, the cleft is... May I?
Stuart, take off your pants and,
Go ahead. The cleft is... Do you mind if I lower the rim of the briefs just a tad?
No, I don't mind. Go ahead.
Now, this obviously is crack.
Mm-hmm.
But right up here, the crack transitions into the cleft. I would say, as a rule, any region where natural light would cast a shadow is off limits. But please, don't try any fancy lighting tricks on us. Natural light.
Got it.
We're trusting you here, Peter. I've known this young lady ever since she was 7 years old. I went to her bat mitzvah and her high school graduation. She's like a daughter to me.
Hey, there's no one in this room you can trust more than me. You both know that. Stuart, put your pants on and get the hell out of here.
Hey, how many times do you think you heard that sentence, huh?
Here, honey, go buy yourself a pair of shoes. Let me work out the details.
Thanks, Uncle Bernie. You're the best.
Okay. Bye-bye. Let's stop fooling around. What are we talking about here, Bernie?
Yeah, I think we're talking about $100,000, Peter.
$100,000 and I get to see your nipple?
Peter, for $100,000, you can cram the camera up her ass for all I care.
I noticed that the other producers have chairs with their names.
Chairs. Chairs? You're worried about chairs. You want to be a producer? Fire someone. Don't worry about chairs. Get out there and fire somebody.
I don't know. Cost anyone there.
Yes, you do. That's what you want to do. You want to put the fear of God into them. Fire them.
I don't want them to fear me.
Yes, you do. You want them to be very afraid of you. When you walk on a stage, you want people to go, oh, my God, look out. That's Adam Rafkin, the guy that fires people. Get to work or he'll fire us. Now go fire somebody, and you'll know what it's like to be a producer.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, I'll do it.
Okay, producer boy.
Can I get one? Sorry.
Sure. Hey, congratulations on becoming a producer. You know, one day, I hope to be able to produce.
Oh, these are terrible. Who made these?
Well, I did.
This is your chance. Do it. Do it, Rafkin. Do it. Do it.
You made these? This thing's disgusting. I feel sick now. Where do you get the cojones, man?
Well, they're frozen, and I stick them in the
oven.
Don't
answer me when I ask you something. You know what? You're fired. How do you like that? Fired. Clear out of here. I never want to see your face again.
But I have nothing else. I live in a truck.
I don't care. Fired.
Wow.
Wow. That was very good. Very decisive, Adam.
Yeah, that was fantastic. How do you feel, buddy? That was great. How do you feel?
Not so good. I feel like I hurt his feelings.
Of course you hurt his feelings. You fired him, but you didn't really fire him. You hire the guy back before he even gets to his car. Oh, okay.
Oh my God, Larry the caterer shot himself. He's dead.
Oh my God.
Rafkin, you just killed a man.
I'm sorry.
No. That's fantastic. You did it. You're a producer now. You did it. Oh, now you don't have to rehire him. Remember I killed the prop guy? Everyone's gotta kill somebody sometime. Okay, right? The job's not-